Yo, what's going on, everyone? This is Austin from Calling Our Shot, and we are back for some player props and spreads in the NBA for Tuesday, June 8th. We got two games on today, and we're combining them all into one video. We got game two of the Sixers versus Hawks series and game one of the Clippers versus Jazz series. Let me know your favorite bet for today down in the comment section below, and maybe I'll even bet one of them if you point out something really good. A recap from yesterday, and it was terrible, large in part due to the Milwaukee Bucks, who absolutely sold it yesterday. I thought they would have looked better, but I guess this is the playoffs, the postseason, and they absolutely looked terrible. So not much you can do about that. Drew Holiday and Chris Middleton obviously do not hit their overs. I don't know what to do. I sold bad info, I guess. What can you do about that? Suns-Nuggets game. I guess I turned Campazzo into a demon. He hit his over in the first half. Just comical. And then I took Jokic over 6.5 assists at plus 112 in the morning. As the day went on, everyone and their mother hammered that bet. It went up to like minus 182, the same exact bet. No, he ends up with like 3 assists. That's just how it goes. I put at the end of the videos yesterday, I put 2 bets, or like 4, I think 5 bets that I considered in each of the 2 games. Of course, those goes like 4-1. We aren't getting lucky, but we're going to keep pushing through. I appreciate all you guys' support. Subscribe if you're new. Thank you for over 6,000 subscribers. Even though I'm selling out bad info, we'll get back on track today. And if I don't, then the rally cap is coming back tomorrow, and there's no way around that. Without further ado, I appreciate everyone for subscribing. And look at all these all-stars. We really appreciate all these people. The people that get me up in the morning, get me to keep going despite having a recent losing streak. We'll get back onto it. Let's start with the Hawks versus Sixers. Where am I starting? Trae Young. I'm taking his over 9.5 assists, minus 108. And he's been remarkable in his first ever playoffs run. You saw him torch my New York Knicks right up there. And we had no answer for him. And the Sixers did not have an answer for him in the first game. He had 35 points and 10 assists. I can't imagine the Sixers just letting him run wild on him again. Expect them maybe to double team him a little more, trap on the pick and rolls. And I think he hits his open teammates. Maybe John Collins has a bigger game. He had a big game in game one. Maybe he has another big game. And I just think that the teammates will be wide open. They aren't letting Trae Young score 35 points on him again. At least I wouldn't expect him to. But you look at it, Trae Young, he's played a minimum of 33 minutes in every single playoff game. That includes game one, includes all 5 games against my New York Knicks. Well, when you look at Trae's career, when he's played 33 minutes against the Philadelphia 76ers, he's hit this over 9.5 assists in 5 of those 6 games. His one miss ended with 9 on the dot. In the playoffs, he's hit this over in 3 of 6 games, ending on the hook 2 of those 3 games that he missed. So if you want to put him into the same game parlay, I wouldn't mind an 8-plus assist kind of night. But I say he gives us a good shot today and plays pretty well, despite all the double teams and traps from the Sixers defense. If he wants to score 35 again, then so be it, but I'll take a chance at this assist number. I like it. Moving on to his teammate, Bogdan Bogdanovic. I'm taking his over, 16.5 points, minus 120. This line's already started to climb up and up and up, and here's why. You look at Bogdan, he had 21 points, hit the biggest shot of the game in the, I believe, 40 seconds left. They're only up by 3, and he hits a 3-pointer, but yet he still shot 7 for 17, and the 17 is a great number. You know, if he's going to shoot 17 times, I would love to take this over a point. Basically, you're just asking for a point a shot, which he's perfectly capable given how many threes he attempts, but he's been hit or miss on the 3-point line, and he missed some wide open looks yesterday or in game one, so I expect him to knock those down today. And like I spoke about above, I believe the Sixers will hone in on Trae Young. They're going to make someone else beat them, and I think that could be Bogdanovic. I think he will score a lot of points today. You look at his last 25 games, he's averaging 20.6 points per game, including the regular season, including the playoffs, and he's hit this line in 18 of his last 25. That's 72%. I give him a good shot in game two of this series as they hone in on Trae Young and they make someone else score. I'm taking it. I'm taking Bogdan Bogdanovic over 16.5 points and not thinking twice about it. Don't mind his rebounds or assist line. His PRA line is pretty good too. Wouldn't mind any of those. But moving on to the second game, Clippers versus Jazz game one. I do think the Jazz win this game, but I will not bet on the spread because I don't really like either of these two teams. Starting with Rudy Gobert, over 13.5 rebounds, minus 120. Do not mind his points plus rebounds line or his points line, I believe, is 13.5 as well. I'm going to keep this one simple. Clippers, they could either go back to Zubac and start him. I believe Serge Ibaka is not playing today. They could put Zubac back in the starting lineup, or they're going to keep going small, but they're going to have to deal with Gobert either way on the offensive and defensive glass, and I think he's going to absolutely destroy them on both ends. You look at it, Boban, you saw what Boban did, and while I don't know if Boban's got ridiculous touch in the paint, but I still think he's a similar talent. Both of them can exploit defenses if they're too small, and I think that's what Rudy Gobert will do today. If you look at Rudy's last 2 games against the Clippers this season and back in, I believe, February and January, he had 15 and 20 rebounds. He set this line in 3 of 5 games against the Grizzlies, and I think he continues his dominance on the glass today against this Clippers team. I don't like betting on Gobert. I really don't. You don't see me bet on him. I liked Ayton yesterday, and I didn't bet on him because I don't like betting on those guys. But I feel confident about this one, and I will ride with it. Gobert, he always screws me, so I wouldn't be surprised to see him drop 20 points and 9 rebounds today. If he does that, so be it. I'll live with the results. My last play of the day, Donovan Mitchell, over 28.5 points. And I would have normally gone under on this because I just was like, yeah, this seems a little high. But Spida, he's going to have to score some points against the Clippers team. And I think he will do just that with or without Mike Conley today, who I believe is the game he's uncertain to play. And I would love if he didn't. That would really help us out with this line. But Spida's going to have the ball in his hands pretty much the whole game. No one else really dribbles the ball too much on that team. Maybe Jordan Clarkson, but the ball's not in his hands very long because he's firing up a shot immediately after he touches it. You look at it. He's been dominant in the playoffs this season, or in this season, and really throughout his career. He's hit this number in 3 straight games against the Grizzlies, and I believe his shot attempts will be there, and I think he'll get to the free throw line. I mean, he should shoot 20, 25 shots tonight. In his last 8 games versus the Clippers, he's averaged 28 on the dot, so right at this 28.5 line, and he's been shooting 21 field goal attempts. I believe the field goal attempts will rise in the postseason, and he'll get some free throw attempts and foul calls as they are at home, and he's playing motivated. They need to get this win at home. Clippers should be a little bit tired after their 7-game series against the Dallas Mavericks. That's why I'm taking Donovan Mitchell over 28.5 points. I think he gets it done tonight. Here's a couple other plays that I did consider if you want to do your own research on them. As I always preach, do your own research about all of these. If you're not going to be confident in them, you definitely shouldn't be telling me, because I unless you at least are confident in the bets, because I have not been on a hot streak. So, yeah, whatever. Here's the other bets I considered. Jazz minus 3.5. I considered that. Consider the Sixers. Believe they're 5-point favorites. Considered them as well. Royce O'Neal, over 1.5 3-pointers. I think it's plus value. He's hit that in like 3 straight games. I think he's at 3-plus threes in 3 straight. Consider Paul George, over 4.5 assists. Can't go wrong with the Joel Embiid, over 29, 28.5 points. He's been absolutely dominant. But like I said, maybe you want to take those because those went, I believe, 4-1 yesterday. So whatever. We're going to recap all my picks. Trae Young, over 9.5 assists. Bogdan Bogdanovic, over 16.5 points. Rudy Gobert, who a player I don't mind his points or rebounds line, over 13.5 rebounds. And Rudy Gobert's teammate, Donovan Mitchell, Spida, over 28.5 points. I like all these 4 plays. I'm not going to necessarily bet on the spreads. If I were to, I'd be taking the Jazz. I'd be taking both favorites. Jazz minus 3.5, minus 4, and the Sixers minus 5. I think both those teams should come out and win. Obviously, the Sixers need a win. Can't go down 0-2, especially when you play those first 2 at home. And I think the Jazz, they're just a better all-around team than the Clippers. And I think the Clippers are a little bit gassed after that 7-game series. Maybe show a little bit of fatigue with those shots and 3-pointers and whatnot. They need a big game to beat that Dallas Mavericks team from Luke Kennard, Marcus Morris, all of those guys. So those are my plays I'm rolling with, those 4. Let me know your favorite play down below in the description. I appreciate everyone. If you want to join our Discord, it is linked down below as well. Almost 1,800 members in there. And you guys are helping me out with these picks because I've been in a recent slump. I appreciate everyone out there. You guys are the absolute MVPs. Shout out to our COS All-Stars. Let's keep it going. And this has been Austin. I'll catch you guys again tomorrow. Peace.